And hello everyone, welcome back, finally. Welcome back after years and years of, well, no episodes, maybe not years. I believe it's something like 2 months. Well, stuff happened. I actually told you, I think I told you about some of it, the training. It's the military rotation. Then I also have a new job, so getting my head around that was, well, time consuming. It's a cool job actually, but it requires me talking for 8 hours a day. So yeah, I was a bit too tired of it. Plus, if you've watched my last police crime action video, I forgot the name. Man, it's been so long. But yeah, some personal family problems. And the effect is that I haven't been home for month and a half, 2 months almost. Oh yeah, my grandparents decided to go on a vacation, holidays. So yeah, watching for their home also took a lot of time. Yes, quite a few days. They went to the Baltic Sea. That's the only sea we've got, so yeah, they've went on vacation there. Not to swim on or anything, but just, you know, to relax. So I was gone. I was honestly gone. But then something happened. One of you guys, one of people who subscribed to me, entire 10 people, I think I need to make a milestone video or something. Yeah, one of you wrote something very nice, a very nice comment that kind of, you know, gave me the kick I needed to get back into it. I can't promise I'll be doing it regularly because, well, stuff. But I really would like to, you know, I've started this to have fun, and I've been missing it lately. So yeah, I would like to, in every spare hour, to record something at least. I'm sure I'm not gonna record the Witcher series for a while now, and Police Crime Action is, well, not until there are plenty updates to make it more playable. But beyond that, yeah, I would like to record this, especially Starmade, because it's so creative, you know. You get to do stuff and have fun. You make your own game. Of course, I am planning on playing some actual games, non-sandbox games, if you will. One of those, because I'm a big fan of the franchise, might be Star Wars Battlefront 3 when it comes out on PC, because I don't own any of those, what you call them, consoles? Yeah, consoles. So yeah, when it comes out on PC, I hope I'm gonna have money for it. I know, I've realized just now that I've never heard a YouTuber complaining that he doesn't have money for games, but really, guys, last few months were tough as far as money go, so I have to, you know, take it slow. Now, right now, If you were wondering what I'm doing, I'm planning out a layout of corridors on the ship. We're gonna have several decks. We are gonna place those corridors, or at least mark where they should go. And then we should start placing weapon systems. Have you heard about this new update for Starmade? Now the ships have an HP other than just the core, which is a step in the right direction, if you ask me. Not that anyone does, but I think I've actually supported some suggestions of this on the forums, on the game forum, developer forum. Oh yeah, I'm also sick again. Well, an outdoor life for me. So yeah. No, I've been gone so long, I thought I would have many more things to talk about, but nope, I'm freezing up right now. Well, I have a lot of my mind. I'm going to the hospital today also to pick up a friend of mine. I've been in every hospital in this city, which is, by the way, Kraków, if you ever wondered. I've been in every hospital in the city in the last 3 months with her daughters. And I've had my fill of tragedies. Not real tragedies, I don't want to someone think that something horrible happened to me. Not horrible, but time consuming and sometimes annoying, sometimes, you know, these events keep you down. What? Oh yeah, okay. Wait just a second. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 high, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, don't lag. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yup. As you can see, you can compare this ship right now as it looks to what you saw in the last episode. I haven't even had time to sit on my computer in those 3 months. So you haven't lost anything. I was really surprised. Oh god, so embarrassing. I have to look up. I'm sorry, gentleman who has commented and said that I should record more videos. I'm sorry, I've at this moment I don't remember your name. I've just got back home and I'm living in, well, what time is it? It's 1 o'clock p.m. and I'm living in 1.5 hours. So I have things to think about, but I will, I promise, I will look up your name. I'm gonna give you a shout out because you were greatly inspiring. Well, your comment was. And I was really surprised that I was intelligible to other people. I honestly thought... I honestly thought I would be hard to understand. I've watched some, you know, non-English speakers trying to record in English, and the effects were not encouraging. So really, I was just recording this for me, and now I'm surprised someone actually watched this. I've even discovered there is a... on my channel, there is a section, statistics, it's called, and you get to... Well, you get to see how many people watch and how they watch and how often do they watch entire episodes, and it's not a great number, I must say. So I was honestly under the impression that I'm just recording this for myself. Glad I was wrong. Very, very happy about that. But yeah. Oh yeah. I was wondering if someone somewhere knew of a good server where I could, because I realized creating an LP by yourself is, well, it's boring. In the long run, it's actually boring. So I would like to actually make something in group effort. Not necessarily other YouTubers, because, well, how do I put this? I don't know anyone except Nathan, who I would like to, talk to. But then again, these episodes take so long to record, and I have so little time that I really would not be available for any actual schedule. Oh, it's a car. I heard the sound. What? Okay. We're gonna figure out something here. But yeah, I also want corridors going sideways, and maybe this one should go a bit further. Further. Yes, further. Very good. I'm also quite surprised that I even remember how to speak English after so much time. Not really, just joking. Ha ha ha. Things to talk about. Nope, no ideas. Yeah. Did I ever mention why this is here? Because, as far as I know, actually, let's check that. Do we have inventory shop ship? Okay, so I don't think we have, yeah, we don't have any fleet commands, and so we cannot have another carrier, for example, following us. Therefore, we will have to have our own shuttle here. By the way, ships now actually calculate its center of mass, and that was the biggest problem. This is why so far I haven't even started on this shuttle, because the idea I had for it would make it flip over on planets face forward. And now that we actually will have a center of mass calculated, I think I can finally start doing something about it. How much money do we have? How much money? 600,000. Yeah, that's not good. Do we have any glass? No, we don't have any glass in our factory. Oh, hat them. I didn't said god damn, I said hat them. I'm sorry, is them saying like god damn or something? Is it a curse word? Because when I've been to States, I once said hell or something like that, and then kids around me reacted like they said it was a curse word or something. Really? Is it? Not sure. Yeah. So now, oh yeah, I remembered. I wanted to do something, so it's gonna be here. I want to create side exits. Side exits from this. Oops. Yep. Now, which one? I think it's this one. Okay. Yeah. Two high, one wide. It'll be enough. Sort of airlocks, because you always have to leave the ship from time to time. and I want to have entries close by. These will also excuse me, frog. This will also, I think, lead to the turrets, because this time around I want to have turrets that are more integrated, not just plopped down on the hull like this in our old ship. Okay, now we need to remake this. So, how you guys been doing? What have you been doing? I've been, well, mostly I've been watching other YouTubers when I have the time. Oh my god, I've been watching Game of Thrones. Ain't that crazy stuff that happened? What else? Oh yeah, I've been thinking about what should I build next. I mean, next when I finish this next year, I'm gonna start building something new. I was wondering if anyone has any suggestions. I would like to stay away from recreating stuff from, well, at least on the channel here, recreating stuff from franchises like Star Trek, which is completely not my alley, not up my alley, or Star Wars, which is completely up my alley, but just no. And also, you know, Mass Effect. I'm a big fan of Mass Effect, but I don't feel like recreating ships in block-based sandbox like this would work. But virtually because we have too many limitations. I already told you I would like to see at some point this game having what are they called, mini blocks, you know, one one thousand of this block, so just a little cubes like this, each block divided 10 rows, 10 layers and so on. That would be pretty cool. Okay. Yes, everything. Yeah, everything looks cool. Now, do we want? Yes, we do want exits and entries here as well. Or maybe not. Too many entry points. I mean, it's not like someone can board through the. Oh god. So destroyed. Not like anyone can board through these, even if we end on a server, because there are faction blocks, right? So they would protect us. But we also need some exits and entries on the bottom and so on. You know what? Let's add them. And then all the systems will be in between. Wait, what am I doing? No. This is the flaw. Here. I think. No, undo. Yes, and touchdown. That's right. No. Why do I keep doing this? Come on, one more. That's right. So this is the internal structure of this ship. There will be. When I build the systems, I'm gonna build access points to them and also some rooms in free areas, maybe some command points. Oh yeah, weapon stations. Instead of the bridge, they would be just next to the weapons. That would be cool. actually. Yeah. That sounds vaguely promising. And here we should also have one of those exits. I'm wondering if we should have some escape pods. Well, not like we're gonna need them in single player, but if you guys come through and point me to, well, a com server with some nice people where there are no curse words in the chat and people don't try to murder you unless you try to, then I would like to have an escape system from my ship, obviously somewhere in here. Ah, I'll think about it. So yeah, these are the corridors. We don't have nearly enough blocks to finish them, but I want to just create a section so you guys can know what I'm planning here. Yes. Definitely no. Yes. One more. Come on. Okay, and now we will have lighting. I think we're gonna have lights, white lights up here. And then we're gonna have red combat lights, alert lights. Maybe on the floor, you know, not lines, but single lights every five or so blocks. That would be actually very cool. And of course, only red lights in these corridors. Yeah. That looks cool. Let's maybe, well, is it five? Is it six, seven wide? I didn't even realize it's seven wide. Let's do it. I'm gonna use up the rest of the blocks. Well, we've got seven left. All right, so actually I'm looking at the time. It's definitely not the time to finish this episode, so let me cut here for a moment and I'm gonna gather more blocks because as you can see we are out, which means I will probably have to go mine asteroids, then put it in well, in our factory, and then finish recording this episode, which means I will probably do it tomorrow because in an hour I'm leaving now. Do I have any white hull? No. Have gray hull? Brown advanced armor for plugging up hulls, combat hulls. Purple hull. Green, orange. We can use these to color code later on. Like, this is torpedoes, this is. No, these will be beams, these might be torpedoes, and these might be, I don't know, point defense? Or maybe blue hull could be point defense. Yep. You see, guys, I've got everything figured out. Mostly. Okay, get out of here. Right, so you guys enjoy this quick cut, and I will see you now. Welcome back. Actually, I've managed to do it pretty quickly. I've looked up the recipe for those things. It's well, it's the next day still, but I've managed. Just whoa, what's going on? gravity neutralized. So yeah, I've been to work and came back, have some free time, so I am recording again. So maybe I don't think I've told you about my new job. I did speak earlier about my job as a security guard, and believe me, there are very few jobs that are more grueling and terrible, and well, not very well paying than a security guard. I am subscribed to a guy named Splattercat. Go check him out if you don't know him. And he has a thing against being a roofer, because he was one, and he remembers it being a terrible job. To be honest, yeah, that's his feelings about it are kind of the same than mine are on being a security guard. Minus toxic fumes. Yeah, being a security guard is just like that, minus toxic fumes, but then again, you have to smell smelly people all day, every day, all day long. And when air conditioning gives up in the shop, which happens on a regular basis, you really have toxic fumes there, believe me. So now I work in air-conditioned rooms, or well, rooms, I guess, works here. Excuse me, still got this cough. Too much talking. I've been talking for 8 hours today, but it's, you know, I'm a telemarketer for a company that doesn't like to its workers to tell other people that it's this company, so I'm not gonna tell you which company is it. It's a phone company, a cell phone company. I had their phone with them for a while before I gotten a better deal from my provider now. But the point is, it's a cool job. I just sit, call people, and ask if they would like me to work out a better plan for them. And you know, most people agree. I have twice as much paid per hour as I did as a security guard, plus provision for everything I sell, plus no one will punch me in the face with a bat. No angry football fans or something like that. So yeah, it's a job with the future, or at least a job without the need of a dental plan. I'm not sure what will happen here at the end of this corridor. Maybe, I don't know. We'll figure it out later. For now, I would just like to have the corridor. I forgot to create more white lights. So this episode will take 3 days, because to make this 10,000, guys, I had made 10,000, almost 10,000, almost or over 10,000, something around 10,000 of those white holes. Do you know how I did that? Well, I've gathered resources in those 2 hours, and I've gathered a lot of them, and the computer was running throughout the night to be able to crunch through all of that. And it did. You have to give it credit for actually not crashing in the middle of the night when I was sleeping, because I was very tired. Yesterday my friend was exiting a tram. I'm not sure how many of you know what a tram is. People in I think the only other place in the world when I know there are trams is San Francisco. And beyond that, I'm not sure if they have them in London in the UK or in France. No, I think they do have them in France. Yeah, I think they do. Well, she was exiting one of those, and this one, usually they are, how do you call them, flat bedded? You know, where the floor is on the same level as pavement, very comfortable, and if you are disabled, you won't have any problem exiting or entering. But this line has, every line has at least one of those old, traditional, you know, restored trams that used to run in just after the war. You know, just as a tourist attraction. And they are definitely not flat bedded, and they have steps, three steps to get up and down. Pretty much like old trains. You have to really pull yourself up. And yeah, this was this kind of tram, and it's been raining all day yesterday. First day of real rain here. I was so glad. Finally could breathe. But those steps, of course, have rubber on them, but they were wet. And she slipped and she hit her but the back of her head. And you know, emergency rescue came and they took her to the hospital, and kids were. Her older daughter, that day, she just got out from a hospital on her own issues. So I had to run over to pick her up because her mom wouldn't, couldn't, because she was in the hospital. She didn't lose consciousness or nothing, but they had to keep her over for observation. And then the younger one obviously went out to her friends, didn't take a cell phone, didn't take the keys to the house or a flat where they live. So obviously now we cannot, now we're waiting for her, me and her older sister, waiting for her to visit her their mom. And she's nowhere to be found, so yeah, I had a pretty stressful yesterday. And but yeah, this friend of mine is leaving hospital at 3 o'clock. It's now 1:30. She left yesterday, and yeah, we'll see. I hope nothing, obviously. She got an MRI and an RTG. I'm not sure if RTG translates to English. You know, the same thing they do to check if your bones are okay, but they did it on her head. And MRI to see if there's no brain damage. And she's fine. Home. Oh. What am I doing here? Corridors. I'm doing corridors. Why don't I speak about corridors? Now that I've built them, they seem like, why did I do that? What was, maybe I'll add rooms here because there's plenty of space over here for weapon systems. And remember, there's only gonna be one siege cannon per each of those, you know, one here, one here, one here, one here, four on each side. I'm sorry. I've added these as a sort of protection, so I hope they work. They will work. Yeah, so far so good. And let me maybe add floors before we finish this episode, because now I have to calculate from 2 days over. So we had like 20 minutes yesterday. Today we have maybe 20 minutes. Oh God, I don't remember. I don't want to give you a unfull episode after this long wait. You guys deserve you 10 special guys and gals, possibly, deserve a full episode, but yeah, I think we are closing on it. Let me know. How long was it? 30. Let's do 30 and how high? 5. Yes. Yes, no. 3. Good. 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 Yep. Looks like a proper corridor. And I'm planning on implementing quite a few logic systems in this build. Not just the red alert, but also automatic doors and lights. Oh, that would be cool if all the lights were off until someone enters the corridor and then they turn on. But yeah, that would require switches here and here at every exit and entry to the corridor. We'll think about this. This is actually an interesting idea. My grandpa is an electrician or electronics technician, so I would have to actually ask him how to create a circuit like that. Because he would know, and I am not gonna be figuring it out all off on my own. Oh, by the way, as far as circuitry goes, my car is falling apart. Yep, I have a 10-year-old Punto 2. It's a Fiat. And it served me surprisingly well for a Fiat. It's one of the reasons why I haven't changed it for something else. I don't even care that people think Fiats are funny little cars and embarrassment to a real man. No, I live in a city that was built for horses and carriages and pedestrians. Driving here in a big car with big engine is, well, it would kill me and my wallet because this Fiat, it's a great car for a city dweller like myself. And still, if I want to go outside of the city into the woods, for example, or go on a picnic on a grill. Is it proper to say I'm going on a grill or on for a grill party? Well, something like that. Definitely no, I'm not the one being roasted. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, it's still capable of traversing mildly difficult terrain, especially the way I drive it. But lately it's electronics were started to give out. I had weird problems with backlights. Like, for example, instead of the flipper, you know, not flipper, you know, the indicator, yeah, that's the word. The indicator, instead of indicator flashing, it's the braking light that's flashing, and the indicator only turns on when I hit the brake. Weird stuff like that. So we've repaired this, and immediately after, guess what? My airbag indicator turned on. Turns out my there's a fuse for those airbags. Well, the fuse burned out for some reason unknown, which isn't a big problem, you'd think, and I didn't think. I've just replaced the fuse. I have spares, right? That's why I have them in the trunk. I have spare fuses, just replaced it, and it's still on. What is going on? Well, it turns out that Fiats have this great computer, have this great onboard computer that records errors in the system, but it does not on its own record when the problem, the error, has been removed. So now I have a fully functional car, as far as like electronics go, that indicates a big malfunction, because airbags that aren't working are considered critical malfunctions. So if police stops me for whatever reason and they see that, I will lose my car. Not like they won't like steal it from me and then drive away. They will confiscate it and I will have to pay for something I can do practically on my own, but I forgot. I was gonna do it yesterday, but I forgot to take my laptop to my grandpa, because my grandpa has these cables necessary to connect a computer to the onboard computer and just delete these errors. We've done it before. I mean, it's not like it's so complicated. I have the right software for it. It's a freeware version. It's not licensed or anything. So I use it on my own. How do you say? On my own risk. But it's cheaper than going and paying someone to do something so virtually so simple. Because you just connect a cable to the laptop and to the car. There's a special socket there. And you just run this program and click delete all errors. And it's not like it's dangerous or something. You can do it yourself. There's no law against it. Because even if you delete all errors, if there are still some malfunctions, those errors will come back. So you will know which one you actually removed and which one you didn't. In this case, I already know I've removed all important errors or malfunctions, but the error stayed, unfortunately. And now I'm driving around looking out for a police. I feel like a gangster, and I probably look suspicious too. But well, the things we do for our car, right? We are almost done here. Too high. Well, it doesn't really matter. Yep. For a second there, I thought I've run out of of hull blocks. So yeah, until I've started recording these episodes and figure out I have to talk about something, I thought I had a pretty boring life, but now that I recount just the events of the last week, I must say I would like a bit of boredom in my life. Honestly. Come on. Maybe I haven't even talked about this ship this entire time, which is actually alright. But just to point out what we're gonna do, I'm gonna close this off, not like this, but create something like this here. What is this? Something in the shape of a box here. I'm gonna armor it, and this will be our shuttle bay. Where will the entry be? Because we have this will be the main shaft. I'm not sure if we're gonna do stairs or gravity switches here. Maybe it's gonna be gravity switches. Yeah, No one said this has to be. It's one of the concepts I really wonder why they haven't used in more science fiction games, like in Star Wars and Star Trek, and especially lately, because these old ideas about like Star Wars and Star Trek, they you can see these people thought of future in abstracts. And today, with like a series like Mass Effect, which is in my opinion the only one that can be compared to the previous two, the both Star Wars and Star Trek, it's different because they think more practically about the gadgets and technology, and well, I almost said culture, but yeah, actually culture too, I must say. But they also never use this concept, which is like, why? This concept that if you already have ships where people obviously live in gravity, why don't you, I don't know, use that gravity to your advantage? Why have lifts if this could be a big corridor? You just, how do you do that? You just, maybe there will be a step here. No, I have an idea. You have a step here. One step. You step down, you hit, it will be somewhere here, and you just walk further. And then you walk here to here. There is a switch here, you hit it, you land here, and you walk further. I mean, there's no point in gravity being a fixed thing on a spaceship, if there is any. If you are in a universe where gravity can be manipulated. And practically it can be, guys. Just because we haven't, do you sorry, I got a freeze. But what I'm trying to say that today manipulating gravity is impossible, and impossible to imagine, because we don't even know what gravity really is. This quantum theory doesn't really explain it, unless you assume that gravitons exist, which we don't know if they exist, because we haven't really. There are suggestions in the code of the world, if you will, that gravitons do exist, but there is really no hard evidence. But that doesn't mean that we won't be able to manipulate gravity. And what I wanted to say as an example is that in, I think, 18th century England, the elite of England was absolutely convinced that everything that there was to invent has already been invented. So they started an actual petition to close down patent offices. Because if everything that ever could be created has already been created, then why pay for an unnecessary, well, bureaucratic entity? Well, that's what I mean, guys. Something, the future is inconceivable to people like us, and it always was, always will be. And I don't even know why I'm talking about it, given that no one is arguing me, because I'm alone in my room, in my home, flat, whatever. Guess I just like talking. Yeah, I'm a talker. I really wish I was a silent, strong type, but I'm a talker. And my mom was very, well, she wasn't very happy that I have this new job. She doesn't think much of it. But she was laughing that finally I've gotten a job that suits my natural talents. Come on. We are almost at the end of this episode. there was a lot of talking, not many, time lapses, because I had plenty to talk about. Not all of it made sense, but it doesn't matter. What matters is that we have met again, and I think I've said everything I can and wanted about my situation. Oops. So guys, I hope you will understand that the episodes will show up very irregularly, because I need hours and hours to record them and to edit them. I've already edited throughout the night. I've edited that part that I've recorded yesterday, and the part I've recorded today I will be editing through the night again. And probably if I find some time in the evening, I will go and mine some more asteroids to create the lights that we need to light up those corridors. Because right now, yeah, it's dark. So thank you guys for watching. Please comment, like, subscribe, and especially comment, because that really warms my heart. And I will see you. In the next episode? One day? Maybe. Just a second. I know I should have finished that episode right now, but God, I wish there was a way to align ships together. What? Oh yeah. We have now several. What? Use left to activate, open. Right to deactivate, close. Oh, that's cool. So yeah. Again, guys. How do I dock? Hello? Okay, what in the actual, you know what I want to say, but I won't say it. Hey, I'm talking to you. Well, I wanted to end this episode on the bridge, but apparently something is broken. So let me go to my file. I'm gonna have to board our miner anyway, so might as well. So again, and for the last time, please comment, like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye bye.